episode 85, Sophie and Lou. Sophie was shy. So shy, she did her shopping during the low hours so she wouldn't have to talk to anyone. Every Wednesday, the bookmobile parked in front of the supermarket, and every Wednesday, Sophie almost went in. But the librarian was so tall! Sophie walked home, minding her bags and watching her feet. Sophie's house was dust-free. The furniture gleamed. The windows shone. She could sit for a long time, watching the sun creep across the walls. "Oh my," she said, twirling her duster. "What are they up to over there? Nobody's been in that house for years." During the following weeks, Sophie watched anxiously as the building was torn apart and put back together again. A banner went up: "Kick Up Your Heels, Dolores and Rudy Dance Studio." "Lots of strangers coming and going," she said. One of the strangers tipped his hat. Sophie drew the curtains. Dolores and Rudy danced well together. Little snatches of music came in waves. Sophie saw a few students now and then. Soon, Sophie couldn't stay away from her window. "Gentlemen, gentlemen," Rudy would cry, clapping. "Lead your lady, don't push her. Elbows up, please. Nose over the toes, and again. 1, 2, 3, 4. "Ladies, ladies," Dolores would plead. "Straight backs, but move those legs. Look at your partner, and then slowly up to the chandelier, and down to the right. And now again." On Wednesday, she climbed the stairs to the bookmobile. She swallowed. "Do you have any books on learning how to dance?" "Certainly," said the tall librarian, and knew just where to reach. Sophie took her books and fled. Safe and home again, Sophie pushed all the furniture against the walls and painted dancing steps on the floor. Blue for waltz, red for tango, green for foxtrot, orange for polka, and purple for samba. She practiced during the day, humming and counting. At night, she danced along with Dolores and Rudy. "I look mousy," she decided one night. "I need something that swings and bounces." She looked into her closet. "Who wants to come out and dance?" she called. Way in the back hung her old best, but the shoes were hopeless. The next day, hiding behind her shopping bags, Sophie slipped into a shoe store. "I need some shoes, please," she whispered. "I'm a dancer," she added a little louder, and sat down. There were boxes and boxes full of shoes. She tried them all. "Where do you dance?" the sales lady asked. "Oh, with Dolores and Rudy," Sophie said, blushing. On her way out, someone rushed to open a door for her. Sophie knew she had seen him before. "I like his face," she thought. All the way home, she danced inside. That night, Sophie put on her old best and new shoes. Finally, she heard Dolores. "Your positions, ladies. Pick your partners." "Oh well, here we go all alone." 1, 2, 3, 4, Sophie sang, barely looking at the green stems for foxtrot. She circled and swayed, all the while holding her arms out to the empty air around her. The music stopped. But Sophie went on. Beautiful chandelier, 3-4, because she knew she had it, 3-4. And to the door, 3-4, and open wide, 3. My name is Lou, he said, bowing from the waist. May I have this dance? You bet, said Sophie, and stepped into his arms.